Hi everybody, welcome back to another VEINet tutorial. In this video, we're going to learn how to use INET and VEINs together to simulate a V2V network. Thankfully, VEINs has a subproject already created called VEINs INET, and we're going to be using this. So here is my workspace. I have INET, my VEINet tutorials project, and VEINs, and they're all in it. My VEINet tutorials repo is available on GitHub, and there's a link in the description below to the repository. So let's expand VEINet tutorials. Under the source folder, I have the VEINs INET folder, and this is the VEINs INET source code. You don't need to do this. You can import the VEINs INET subproject, but this is my preferred way with VEINs INET, because as you're simulating VEINet environments, you may find yourself modifying this code. Just so you know, that if you opened up VEINs under subprojects, there is the VEINs INET. This works with 4.0, and then VEINs INET 3 works with INET 3. The VEINs INET subproject, as you can see, is included in VEINs, and it allows for us to use VEINs as a mobility module in either INET 3 or INET 4. And the version that we're working with is INET 4. So the VEINs INET project helps us use the full feature set of the INET framework in a VEINs simulation. With this, we can access full IPv4, IPv6 stacks, wired networking, mobile ad hoc network protocols, bit precise PSAP traces, or network emulation. So using VEINs INET, we can also model libraries based on the INET framework, which is really useful. And so now that we could use things like SimuLTE, which is a 4G simulation. So this is the VEINs INET subproject. I've also put in my simulations the VEINs INET example simulation. This example illustrates how VEINs INET is used. So let's look at this network. So if we go into the scenario, you can see that we have our radio medium set up. We have a manager, which is using the VEINs INET manager. And then we have nodes, which are the VEINs INET car. If we inspect the VEINs INET car, you can see that it extends ad hoc host. So these nodes represent our cars, and they actually inherit the standard INET wireless host, and they'll use a regular INET network car. So each car uses a mobility module of the type VEINs INET mobility. This is set in the OMNET PP INI file. So here you can see that the VEINs INET mobility, it's accessing the node, setting the mobility type to VEINs INET mobility, which is defined in our source. So VEINs INET mobility, this is the NED file for the VEINs INET ability, and the code for the mobility is available right here. The VEINs INET mobility ends up implements the INET mobility base, and it also accesses the Tracy scenario manager, which is how VEINs normally works. So this is our tie-in from VEINs to INET. Last but not least, you can see that there is a manager. This is a global module, VEINs INET manager, and it creates and manages cars in our simulation. So let's go back to our OMNET PP INI file. So this is the general configurations for the VEINs INET example simulation. It sets the network to scenario. It sets up the sim time limit to be 60 seconds. It has some other settings for debugging on errors and the image path. The important part is our UDP basic app. So the node inherits our wireless host. So in this case, it is setting up our UDP app to be using the VEINs INET sample application. We're going to look at the code for this in a minute, but let's finish looking through the settings on our INI file. It sets the interface to a wireless LAN. And with that set up, it sets up the wireless LAN interface, the operation mode, the radio band, the bandwidth, all that information as well. This is the host auto configurator. In order to configure a network stack for our cars entering a simulation, an additional host auto configurator model needs to be included with each car. This is very similar to how when the dynamic version of AODV is simulated, it has to have its own auto configurator. This is setting the VEINs INET mobility, which I pointed out before, and these are the settings for the INET manager. So this will do the update interval, the location, the local host connection, the host connection to the sumo environment, the port that it's connecting to. So when you run this simulation, you need to be sure that you're also starting up sumo. All right, so now let's look into the VEINs INET sample application. So the VEINs INET sample application has the ned file, which just registers the class VEINs INET sample application. So this is the header file. The header file extends the VEINs INET application base. Inside the C++ file, the start application checks if the node is the first node, so host 0, and sets the display to be red, and then sets the speed to be 0 to stop it. So this is actually how it accesses the vehicle to stop it. And then that host will create a VEINs INET sample map message with the size of 100 bytes. It sets the road ID and then creates a packet called accident and then sends that packet along. It calls the send packet, which is part of the VEINs INET application base. When it receives a packet, which is process packet, it colors the vehicle as green, and then it'll change the route to whatever road ID was given. It's just a very simple application that shows you how you can manipulate different items in VEINs and INET. So the application base extends our INET UDP socket and also INET's application base. So this is doing all the UDP and networking for us. So now that we've looked at all this, let's run our INET application. First, we need to make sure that we're running sumo. So let's run sumo. So we'll launch the sumo launch Python, launch our sumo application, and now it will be listening on port 9999, which was set in our VEINs INET manager right here. So let's run our simulation. So this is the startup for our simulation. There are no vehicles on there. We have our radio medium and our manager. And actually, if you want to, you can inspect the settings for your manager and your radio medium on the side here. And you can see the different settings that have been set up. So if we start running, so you can see that our vehicles are now traveling and we have node 0, node 1, node 2 slowly coming in. Eventually, node 0 is going to stop at 20 seconds in. There he goes. He stops. He sends out a packet and also received the packet. Now it is sending the packets to the other nodes. And you can see the packet name was accident. It's being sent along our UDP protocol. And node 1 received it, so it turned green. Node 2 received the packet, so it turned green. Node 2 sends a relay to node 0 and node 1. That was received when the packet was accepted. We created a relay that ended up forwarding. So you can watch this. It will take a while. You can speed it up to be faster. The simulation is only 60 seconds though, so it ends very quickly, but now you can see how you have VEINs and INET working together. So now what we want to do is extend this example so that it will work using AODV. So now let's look how to make the VEINs INET example work with AODV. So this will be VEINs and INET working with a routing protocol, which is AODV. So there is a new folder here called routing, and you can get this code on my GitHub, but we're going to walk through how it is set up. So within here, I have a routing scenario. This is very much the same as the scenario earlier. The only difference is that we are using something called VEINs INET Routing Car. Now, VEINs INET Routing Car is something that I created. The difference between VEINs INET Car and Routing Car is that there is a routing submodule. If I expand and go into VEINs INET Routing Car, the same exact code as VEINs INET Car, except there is a submodule called routing that takes in a parameter called router, and it's like IAP, and that's because AODV is like IAP, and you can use different interfaces as well, so you can implement other protocols. It doesn't have to just be AODV. The other change is that we added some connections, and that is the routing socket out goes into the message dispatcher's in. This is how we're connecting our gates together. And the socket in for routing is connected to the message dispatcher's out. So this is very important because this is how they're going to connect to each other so that we can emulate the network. This is the only changes that we have to do for our NED files. Now let's go and look at the INI file. Going into the OMNETPP INI file. So what has been changed is instead of using the VEINs INET sample application, I'm going to be using the UDP basic app type. The destination address, I'm going to talk to any random node. If you were doing an RSU simulation, you would make an RSU node, and then you can add that node to your scenario. And then here, your destination address could be an RSU. Then we're setting the destination port, the message length, the interval, and then the packet name. In this case, the packet name is just going to be UDP data. The rest of the configurations are the same as we did earlier. Last part is routing. I am setting the router to be AODV. This is going to then access the AODV submodule. So now we are ready to run our code. We right-click, run as OMNET simulation. So let's start our simulation, and our vehicles will start being added to the playground. And they take about 5 seconds each, so we'll speed it up a little bit. So we have our vehicles being added, and now they are communicating back and forth. And if you scroll up, you can see that we send an AODV request. So this was node 1 sending an AODV request to node 0. So now you have AODV working with VEINs and INET, and you have connected all these routing protocols together. Congratulations, you have now learned how to make AODV work with VEINs and INET in OMNET++. If you like what you saw, please remember to subscribe to my channel so you can be notified for more OMNET++ tutorials.